thanks for coming. My name is Chang-Chun, fourth year DMA student, percussion performers. This lecture recital is part of the fulfillment of the DMA degree in percussion performance. Today I'm going to talk about the stick choice for Elliott Carter's eight pieces for timpani. For those of you do not familiar with percussion instrument and repertoire, you have some information about how important a stick difference to the percussionist. For those who play percussion instrument or familiar with percussion instrument or repertoire, this lecture will provide different sort for stick choice for this particular piece. Also can apply to others. Right, why choose Carter's piece? Carter's piece is no question, this four timpani piece is one of the most important work in the contemporary era for percussionists. It gave new perspective for both percussionists and composer concerned potential of non-pitch percussion instrument as a solo voice. And also it turns the timpani into a solo instrument. Since human use like drums making rhythmic, so percussion or like drums always been the accompaniment like to dance for like in orchestra. And into the 1900s, like composers start explore like sounds, give percussion instruments some like new and more important role, like we could see in Soldier's Tale as like a setup. And then like percussion instrument timpani become a solo instrument. However, we have more and more pieces and research for our instrument, but we don't really have like lots of like research like specific for sticks. Right, stick choice is one of the important consideration when performers face a piece either in a solo position or stand in the back of the orchestra. Wrong stick choice will produce sound and music in a completely different direction from the composer's preference. When the stick choice situation comes to timpani, it is a large portion of how timpanists change the sound and character in the music. So that's why I choose this topic, because through making stick choice for Carter's pieces, the performer not only give a piece more musical sense on modern timpani, but also can gain knowledge through the process. Right, let's talk about brief history for timpani. Timpani is a special instrument in the percussion family because it a special combination between rhythmic percussion instrument and tune percussion. And timpani was known as kettle drum, and it cannot always be tuned before. Right, before kettle drum, these little drums called naker was like the things before kettle drum. And because of the like the kettle shape of this, the bottom body, so it becomes like a kettle drum after that. And they when play it, usually you have two drums have relative pitch and one big, one small, and usually the size can hang like on the wrist. And when it becomes to kettle drum, like kettle drum was like a record in the books, like around like mid 15th century in Europe. And it becomes bigger and bigger, like they use for religion and military use. So that's how they hang on the horse and play it. The kettle drum first introduced in the orchestra in the 1600s and was paired with trumpet section. We could usually see in like Vivaldi or Handel's pieces, so usually have like a section with trumpets. Timpani tuning system first appeared in around like late 1600s, and the system was made by several tuning handles surrounding the hoop, like we know. This could control the tension of the drum head. And the large, big army kettle drums were called timpana. So that's why the name timpani came from. is the technology improvement of the 19th century brought the development to the instrument. This change involved like use of mechanical system that could change the tuning of the instrument more quickly and accurately. The timpani played today, now we use, are usually like 4 to 5 drums and range of size 20 inch to 30 inch, usually cover 2 octaves. Back to Carter's piece, 8 pieces for 4 timpani. This piece is composed between 1949 and 1950 and was called 6 pieces for kettle drum. And Carter was not really satisfied because he said, "I couldn't distinguish the pitch of the drum and they all seemed very boring because there was all this unclear swimming sound." After that, a percussionist and conductor called Young Williams helped Carter revise in 1960. And Young Williams' study was Paul Price, so he could like study this Carter's piece, unpublished pieces. And the important revision, including like the beating spot on the drum head and harmonic effect, something like that. So after the revision, like it published like the day we play right now. So the specific beating spot. So Williams like suggests like to have different beating spot, like normal, center, and ring. Normal for normal position and center for center beating position, the center of the drum head. The ring is near the ring but not on it. And you can see this is the original version that Carter did, and there's no notation for like a beating position. And this one is the one now we use. There's like a center, like a normal, like some notation on it. And the center sound give like a articulate and short resonance. On the other side, the ring give like thin and light resonance. Right, different stroke. Also, they give like a natural stroke, normal stroke, and death stroke. Death stroke means you hold down on the drum after striking and damp all the resonance at once. So hit and press. That's usually how I do. Harmonic sound effect. This is a little bit complicated when Young Williams suggests to do this kind of thing. They figured out how to do it is press your finger between the center of the drum head and the ring, and then press it, and then play the edge of the drum, and then release it quickly. So that could have like little bit like a harmonic sound. Right, performance order. Although all 8 pieces have been published in order, this was not the original show from Carter. His performance note, the first one is description concerned in the performance order. He suggests not playing more than 4 pieces at the time. And because this might maintain the fresh idea for pieces to audience. He also recommends that the performers could arrange their own performance order. So today I'm gonna divide it to 2 suites. So I'll show it later when I play it. Right, back to our topic, finding a pair of appropriate sticks. So nice sound is not equal to an appropriate sound. According to Tim Jennings, principal timpanist of the Boston Symphony Orchestra and professor of percussion at Boston University, appropriate sticks need to be considered for 3 main reasons. The first one is fit the excerpts. So for example, when you play Mozart things, you might use like small, hard, articulate stick because of the historical background. Because at the time Mozart doing the symphony, they might not have like a lot of fails stick, usually use like a single cover or wood sticks. Drum tie and drum head to play on, like different drum head, carved skin, plastic skin, or small bulk drums, large modern timpani. And the next one is knowing the character of different type of stick. So knowing what the sound you're making through like different sticks. The ways I'm gonna to find stick choice for Carter's pieces. The first is the suggestion of stick from Carter and Williams. So basically, the performance note from Carter and the article record about like Williams, how Williams worked with Carter and what's the discussion between them, and then the computer added sound comparison experiment. So I'm doing some spectral analysis for the stick sounds, and interview with active timpanists. That's the last one. And after we see these three things, the author, myself, will choose and will do like a suggest the specific sticks for the performance. Right. So you can see your handout, there's like a column and says like there's like column compare, like how Carter and Willis suggest. And I'll do it quick through one movement to movement. Yeah. The first movement said Carter does not really give like things for that, a pair of sticks to bring in our character. And Williams say medium hard stick, rather softer than harder, so do not use too hard. And because this movement, there's like a sound effect, you need to turn the stick to the butt, so use the wood handle to play it, so wood handle might be needed. The second one, molto per proto. Carter and Williams, like, they try to find some special sound, and this is what Carter shows on his performance now. So you have a stick, a core, and then you wrap it up, cover it, maybe 2-3 layers, and then you need to that your tip like coming out, not cover it, and then because some of the part you need to use the tip to play it to make the sounds difference. Next, adagio, pair of stick, bring the sound, bring the character, Carter say, not big different, but Williams suggests with smaller head. Why smaller head? We'll talk about it later with the sound experiment. Right, recitative, the fourth one, a pair of stick to bring character, again, that's the same. And then special is the end of the note, we use the soft bass drum on it. And Williams suggests avoiding mother that are too soft. Improvisation, Carter again, lazy, say the same thing. Williams says stick can make the articulate sound. Next, candle. Snare drum stick is what they suggest to use in this particular pieces. Actually, this piece is made for like snare drum stick use because both Carter and Williams want some like special effect. At that time, use snare drum stick to play it, like a buzz roll sound, it's cool. Right, canaries, stick could bring out the character. Again, the same, a pair of sticks sounding articulating. Yeah, that's it, march. Right, wood handle timpani mallet, because Carter introduced use the head and the butt at the same time, so wood handle. Williams goes with Carter. Right, let's go to the interesting things that I did for this research. Right, so the computer added sound comparison experiment. So the I actually inspired by this book when I searched in the library, Timpani Tone and the Interpretation of Baroque and Classical Music by Steven Schweizer. And this book, this author said, like the different color sound of timpani could be seen, like on the graphic or give it like a scientific perspective way to do it. And then he Parker gave like objective evidence of like spectrum comparison can help performer how like we discover the sound, not rely on ear, because we usually just like, hey, this sound is like soft or big, and this sound is more articulate, but there's like no objective evidence for it. So this is how I really want to do this one, right? And also on that book, there's like a little page filled one paragraph to saying that, so it is worth to like extend that experiment and also the experiment like stuff in like for modern timpani. So this is how I set up the experiment. The speed are only the varying factors, so everything apart from that are the same. So the first one, same recorder, the same distance, the recorder from timpani, the same strings, stroke on timpani, the same pitch, the same size, same seconds. I actually record 5 seconds because after 5 seconds, the timpani sound like randomly. And I use a program called Audio Scope. It cost me a lot, like $200. And I use a pitch. I use a 220 hertz. That's like the 440, like the lower octave of that. Right. Here's the graphic. Now we can actually see the sound, not only hearing the sound. Right, okay. So if this picture is not like clear, the handout, there's like the one you can have a look at on that. Right, okay, how to read it? The x-axis, like this, is time. Every grid shows like 1 second, so that's 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds. And the y-axis shows the frequency in hertz. So 2000 hertz represented each grid by line. So 2000, 4000, 6000, so above. And the black portion you guys see now is the body of the sound. So the higher hertz, like this, at a beating point, it's like how the sound give more articulations. Because the human hearing system, when you can hear something clear, articulate, that means this state or things bring out like the higher hertz for human, for our ears. And the lower hertz is basically like the main body of the sound. So now we can explain. When you hear the center sound, we say short articulate. We say short and articulate. Yeah, so that's here. Oh, sorry, my bad. Not articulate, so you can hear this, the sound. The normal timpani sound, that's the normal sound, the ring sound. How to explain it? The ring sound, because there's more like overtones, harmonics coming out. So you can see there's a little bit like spot from beating point. That's how this stick bring the position bring out. And the normal is kind of like you have a beautiful shape on it. And the center, we heard that really short, it fade out like quickly. So through time to time, it fade out. So here, we got some like white blank things happen. So as we got these knowledges, now we could compare some sticks. So bow tie. So bow tie stick is like general stick for timpani. So I'm using the Genus series 1, 5, 6, 7, 8 for this experiment. Right. The Genus 1 is the, we usually say is the softest one. So when it's soft, we hear the sound soft, not articulate. So you can see here, it's only not exist 3000 hertz. So it gives like a low roaming sound. It comes to like a Genesis 5. It gives a little bit more articulation to bring out the like a higher hertz. The Genesis 6, you can see not a lot different, but you can see around the line here at 2000 hertz, it's a little bit different. Genesis 6 bring out a little bit more, and this one bring out less. So that's why like we could hear like the difference between that. So let's play the Genesis 1. That's Genesis 1, like the soft mallets. It's Genesis 6. You have more like punch for 6. Then to 6, to 7 and 8, it's more obvious. You can see like Genesis 8 give out like really like a rich 6000 hertz. However, compared to Genesis 1, not exist like 2000, so the sound makes difference. Let's compare it. I 100% sure I played it at full straw and the same strength. Yeah, that's the difference. And let's go to the next one, finalizes. We usually see like a car wheel mallet, and because the shape, so it got like less contact with the drum head, so the sounds look like this. You can see even the soft flannel mallet give the attack, you can hear the attack sound like compared to the failed mallets, because it gives out like more hertz for that. However, you can see compared to the fail mallets, when time to time, the fail mallet have like more steady, like more black when like the time pass around like 3 seconds. But however, the flannel mallet, like the sound is thin and light, so it drop dramatically and then fade out quickly. Right, next one I use is stick without wrapping. So I use bow tie wood mallet, snare drum stick, and bottom end of the wood handle. Looks like this. So as we know, the wood stick might be really sharp sound, really articulate. All of these three over 16,000 hertz. But it all really dropped really quickly within like a 0.5 seconds. So it sounds like this. We have the attack, really attacks. But three of them are all pretty much the same. So next one. The one I use for the second movement, Moto Percuto, the special cover rattan mallet. Carter and Williams say the mallet need to like could bring out like light sound, more ringing sound. So after I have like revised of those mallets like this, I use the rubber band as the core and then medical tape for the cover, and then the sound like this. The spectrum analyze shows I might be success, because this they could bring out a lot of ringing sound and then short and thin sound, light. So this stick works well for that. So we could hear that when I play it. Right, the result for this experiment. This experiment shows that spectrum analyze reflect the articulation, sonority, length of the sound, and unique character of different type of sticks. This scientific method offer more information about the character of different type of sticks to to the performer when they choose this. Right, next one. Interview with Tim Jennings. So, with consideration of the original song of Carter and Williams regarding stick choice and comparing different type of sticks through the experiment, it is also worth having various performers share their experience with Carter's timpani piece. So, this interview engaged Tim Jennings, who is an important figure of timpani music. Not only important in his role as performer, Professor Jennings also made and improved the timpani stick to pursue a better sound quality. Also, because he worked with Carter for these pieces, so it is worse for that. So, these three questions was offered to Mr. Jennings. First one is, when facing timpani extra or piece, what is your concern about choosing the stick? That's the first one. When playing a contemporary solo timpani piece with no specific stick requirement for the composer, how do you choose your stick? Will you choose the stick that could reveal the composer's original musical idea? Or will you choose something else to display your own character? The third one is, according to your realization of Carter's pieces, what is the stick choice for each movement from you? And also give a little bit detail about your choice. Right, so the first question already answered when we talk about like the main fact, like the three main facts, how to choose the stick. So the next one is the question, when facing like a thing, no specific stick choice pieces, Mr. Jennings say he considered about both of like the original idea from the composer and a little bit from his own idea, so basically like both. Next one, we're running quick. General, the stick choice for from Tim Jennings. The first one, center. General bow tie fill mallet to bring out the lyric quality of pieces. The second one, the second movement. He say he will like use the rotten stick, basically just make a stick. And the third one, small light fill stick. Now we can like thinking about the small light fill stick to bring out harmony effect. Why? Because when we saw the comparison of the sound experiment, when you want to do like a more ringing sound or more like a overtone sound on timpani, if you are using like something like Genesis 1, very soft, very big mallet, you cannot bring it out anything. See, under 2000 Hz, that's everything. However, if you use it like a small sticks, even it's really hard to do like a small sound, the piano sound, but you could bring out more overtone harmonic things out from the timpani. So that's why when it comes to like harmonic effect, both Carter Williams, also Jennings suggest use like something smaller. Recitative, firm bow type fill mallet, so small enough to bring out the intricate rhythms. The fifth movement, improvisation, so bow tie stick and can full tone style. Canto, this is the one that a little bit different, because when Carter and Williams suggest to use the snare drum stick and use that buzz sound to be the main body of the movement, Professor Jennings suggests use the bow tie stick and then use some of the reverse butt end to doing some stuff and then use the fail part to rolling part. He said it more makes sense for like the harmonic sound. And Canary, use the stick, it's like a length felt or like moleskin, basically like single there, like really articulate stick. March, wood stick, so small felt or like the one could like really make the sound different between butt end and the head. Carter the historical background, like the interview with Janice, and then the self-experiment. This is how I suggest, right? So the first one, you can see there's a column in your handout as well. So you can easily see both Carter Williams and Janice like give out like general bow tie belt and medium heart. So I choose Janice 6 as like a like a general use mallet to play this movement. The second movement, the special cover rattan stick. And basically I explained it how I do that sticks. Third movement, snare drum stick with smaller head. We explained that. We have like a smaller head could bring out more like overtone and ringing sound for that. So Janice 8, like the smallest size for that series. Four, recitative sticks not too soft from Carter and Williams. Janice say firm bow type fill mallet. So I suggest to use firm bow type fill sticks. So I use the Janice 7. And the fifth movement, stick that can make the articulate sound. And Janice suggests full style bow mallet. So I use the general bow tie mallet, Janice 6. Sixth movement, snare drum stick. And we just talked about it, that Janice not agrees that. But I'm going with the original idea from Carter. So I'm going to use the snare drum stick. And seventh movement, an articulate stick from Carter and Williams. And Janice says small heart stick and brilliant feel, like single cover. So I use the TG 13 from the Janice series. And it's like a leather cover on it. And the last movement, wood handle timpani stick. Wood handle timpani stick, basically the same. So I choose to use the Cobra flannel mallet, a hard one. And basically it got the wood handle and then has the flannel head with clear sound. So hope could make the difference between the wood sound and the flannel sound. So the conclusion, by looking back to one of the most important pieces by Carter, and of this solo repertoire in the history of timpani, it is worth connecting the past and present, including current technology and musical thinking as part of playing timpani music. The question of stick choice is always an issue for performers. The author's solution, my solution, in this study is only one possibility. However, the study shows the multiple facts one should consider when approaching stick choice for timpani repertoire. So now we are going to play. So I'm going to play divided into two suites. So I'm going to do in order, suite one and suite two. Yeah, let's do it. Thank you. No questions. Okay.